Hi everyone, it's story time. Today we are going to read The Very Lazy Ladybird by Isobel Finn and Jack Tickle. This is the story of a very lazy ladybird. She liked to sleep all day and all night. And because she slept all day and all night, this lazy ladybird did not know how to fly. One day, the lazy ladybird wanted to sleep somewhere else. But what could she do if she couldn't fly? Then, the lazy ladybird had a very good idea. When a kangaroo bounded by, she hopped into her pouch. But the kangaroo liked to jump. "I can't sleep in here," cried the lazy ladybird. "It's far too bumpy." So when a tiger padded by, she hopped onto his back. But the tiger liked to roar. "I can't sleep here," said the lazy ladybird. "It's far too noisy." So when a crocodile swam by, she hopped onto his tail, but the crocodile liked to swish his tail in the water. "I can't sleep here," said the lazy ladybird. "I'll fall into the river." So when a monkey swung by, she hopped onto her head, but the monkey liked to swing from branch to branch. "I can't sleep here," said the lazy ladybird. "I'm feeling dizzy." So when a bear ambled by, she hopped onto his ear. But the bear liked to scratch. "I can't sleep here," said the lazy ladybird. "He'll never sit still." So when a tortoise plodded by, she hopped onto her shell, but the tortoise liked to snooze in the sun. "I can't sleep here," said the lazy ladybird. "It's far too hot." So when an elephant trundled by, she hopped onto his trunk. "At last," thought the lazy ladybird, "I found someone who doesn't jump or roar or swish his tail or scratch or swing or snooze." But at that very moment, the elephant sneezed. "Ah, ah, ah. And poor old lazy ladybird had to fly at last. Thank you.